I wake up, I just get this
feeling in my body, way down deep inside me. I try not to fight it.
Describe it.
All right, a few things start to happen. My vision starts to flatten. My heart, it gets too tapping, and I think I'm gonna die. I was a kid who was stuck in his room. There isn't much more to say about it.
Times are changing and I'm getting old.
It's almost over, it's just begun. Don't overthink this, look in my eye. Don't be scared, don't be shy. Come on in, the water's fine.
Look at where you came from, look at you now. Zuckerberg and Gates and Buffett. Amateurs can fucking suck it.
Are you feeling nervous? Are you having fun? It's almost over, it's just begun.
Start to smell burning toast. You're having a stroke or overcooking your toast.
If you wake up in a house that's full of smoke, don't panic. Call me and I'll tell you a joke.
My current mental health is rapidly approaching an ATL, which is that's an all-time low. Not Atlanta.
Isn't anybody gonna hold me accountable? I'm problematic. I feel like shit.
Oh, shit.
Feeling like a saggy, massive sack of shit.
Oh, shit.
Big ol' motherfucking duffel bag of shit.
Oh, shit.
But look, I made you some content. Daddy made you your favorite open wide.
There it is again, that funny feeling. That funny feeling.
What the fuck is going on?
Could I interest you in everything all of the time? A little bit of everything all of the time.
Are you going to behave yourself?
Yes.
Yes. What?
Yes, sir.
Look at me.
Yes, sir.
Isn't anybody gonna hold me accountable? I'm problematic.
He's a problem.
When I was 17 on Halloween, I dressed up as Aladdin.
Here's a healthy breakfast option. You should kill your mom. Here's why women never fuck you. Here's how you can build a bomb. Which Power Ranger are you? Take this quirky quiz. Obama sent the immigrants to vaccinate your kids.
Seeking for entrepreneur, born in 1964, Jeffrey Bezos. Seeking for entrepreneur, born in 1964, Jeffrey Bezos. Come on, Jeffrey, you can do it, pave the way, put your back into it, tell us why, show us how. Look at where you came from, look at you now. Zuckerberg and Gates and Buffett, amateurs can fucking suck it. Fuck their wives, drink their blood, come on, Jeff, get up.
I can handle this for probably zero more seconds.
It's in their phone, and my first instinct isn't why are they on their phone? It's like, yeah, why would you want to look up at the world right now? Really, for real. Like, of course. Look at the world you made for these kids to look up at. No wonder they're burying their head in the sand.
On that very light note.
Anxiety and stage fright has sort of bled into kids' normal lives.
God, that sweater looks good.
Avocado shirt should I wear to the dinner? Here's ketchup.
Oh, no, no, no.
Oh!
Killed it.
What's up, y'all? It's your boy, Robert, back at you with another sweet-ass video.
I'm doing fine. I'm fine.
Don't overthink this. Look in my eye. Don't be scared. Don't be shy. Come on in. The water's fine. You say the ocean's rising like I give a shit. You say the whole world's ending. Got it already there. You're not gonna slow it.
I'm horny.
I am in love with Bo Burnham.
Of course.
What do you mean, of course? Sarah, you are the fifth patient that has told me you're in love with Bo Burnham in 2 weeks.
Well, that's a relief.
You know that he is sad and broken in the most irresistibly erotic way, and that you can't fix him, right?
Yes.
Also, he does not know that you exist.
Details.
What are you doing? This is a little bit experimental, but I have found it to be very effective with my other patients.
Okay.
Just trust me, okay?
Get your fucking hands up. Get on out of your seat. All eyes on me. All eyes on me. Are you feeling nervous? Are you having fun? It's almost over. It's just begun. Don't overthink this.
Okay, stop. Okay, now I'm in love with you. Okay, that did also happen to the other four. I just really like attention.
All right, so now that everybody's all hyped up about Bo Burnham's special Inside, I can finally tell this story that I never thought anybody would give a shit about. So a couple of years ago, I was working at a hair salon in Northvale, New Jersey, and someone called to book an appointment. The caller ID said R. Burnham, but I didn't think anything about it. They gave me the name Robert, they gave me an address, and it was kind of funky because they gave me a phone number that was missing like one or two digits. And when he shows up, I got this crazy feeling that I knew who he was, but I felt it more like I felt familiar rather than recognized. So I'm trying to help my boss, but I literally cannot stop looking at him. And finally, it's his turn to get his hair cut. So I take him to the back to shampoo him, and I just go, "Hey, you look really familiar." And he said, "Do I?" And I said, "Yeah, I think you do." So he asked me my name. I said, "Hi, I'm Mary." And he said, "Hi, Bo, nice to meet you." And he shakes my fucking shampoo-y hand. I'm like wiping it off on my apron. And he got a haircut, and that's the time that I washed Bo Burnham's hair.
He was super polite, not divish or anything, very patient because my boss was doing a perm right before him and he had to wait a couple of minutes, which I was like freaking out about, but my boss had no idea who he was, so she didn't give a shit. But yeah, he was really chill. He was super nice about the haircut. She gave him a great haircut, but you know, she kept asking, is it okay? Is it okay? Yeah, it looks great. It's fine. So he was really polite. He said, thank you. You know, he shook my hand and everything. It was super cool.
Is this heaven? Or is it just a white woman? A white woman's Instagram. What? Try making faces. Try telling jokes, making little sounds. Well, well, look who's inside again. Went out to look for a reason to hide again. Got you surrounded.
I can't fit my hand inside a Pringle can. I have a huge amount of trouble fitting my hand inside of a Pringle can. I can get my hand like 4 inches into the can, but then I have to tilt the can into my mouth. But by that point, a bunch of crumbs have accumulated at the bottom of the can, so they all go spilling onto my face. What I'm trying to say is the diameter of Pringle cans is way too small. I'll say it again, the diameter of Pringle cans is way too small. Two radiuses of a Pringle can is way too small. If you feel me, put your hands up. Come on. If you feel me, put your hands up. Look at all these hands that are way too big to fit inside a Pringle can. Your hands are too big to fit.
Well, I came to watch some comedy, but instead I got 3 mental breakdowns, and now I have a crush on a skinny white man with a beard.
Are you feeling nervous? Are you having fun? It's almost over, it's just begun.
If I wake up in a house that's full of smoke, I'll panic. So call me up and tell me a joke. When I'm fully irrelevant, totally broken, damn it. Call me up and tell me a joke. Oh shit. You're really joking at a time like this.
Wow, wow, look who's inside again. Went out to look for a reason to hide again.
Feeling like a bag of shit.
Oh no!
Here's a healthy breakfast option. You should kill your mom.
There it is again, that funny feeling.
Daddy made you your favorite open wine.
Oh, interesting, now leave me alone.
I'm asking but don't answer, cause I don't wanna know.
Next year.
You know, I feel okay when I'm asleep. Like, when I'm asleep, I feel all right. But it's basically, from the moment I wake up, I just get this
feeling in my body, way down deep inside me. I try not to fight it.
Describe it.
All right, a few things start to happen. My vision starts to flatten. My heart, it gets to tapping. And I think I'm gonna die.
CEO, entrepreneur, born in 1964, Jeffrey Bezos. CEO, entrepreneur, born in 1964, Jeffrey Bezos.
Come on, Jeffrey, you can do it. Pave the way, put your back into it. Tell us why, show us how. Look at where you came from, look at you now. Zuckerberg and Gates and Buffett, amateurs can